Might not find someone like you. Hey, what's up, everybody? So today I'm going to be cleaning out my closet, and I am going to actually be selling my clothes to a consignment store slash thrift store in New York City. The one I'm going to is called Buffalo Exchange, and they have plenty of locations around New York City as well as in America. And basically, Buffalo Exchange is a store where they sell secondhand items, obviously discounted, and you can also sell some of your old clothes there as well. I've been selling to Buffalo Exchange for quite some time now, since I was in college, and I just think it's a great way to get rid of some of any old clothes that you might have laying around, rather than just throwing it out in the trash. So when you go to Buffalo Exchange, you can present the items that you're going to sell, and the sales associate or the buyer from Buffalo Exchange will go through the items, and if they're able to sell it, they will take your items and they will give you either 50% of what they're going to sell in store credit, or they'll give you 30% in cash. So for example, if you brought an item over and Buffalo Exchange was going to sell it for about, say, $60, then they'll either give you $30 in store credit or you'll get back $20 in cash. So I also want to touch on how the selling process at Buffalo Exchange and other consignment stores work during COVID times. So this is like my second time selling to Buffalo Exchange after COVID-19 hit, and in order to comply with social distancing and to limit the amount of people that are in the stores, Buffalo Exchange actually has set up like appointment times. So you just call the location that you want to go to sell, and the phone numbers are all on their website. You call them and then you just book the appointment. So you tell them what day and time that you want to come in to sell, and you'll then you get a reservation, you get an email confirmation, and then you just show up at that time. So my reservation is today. Unlike pre-COVID times, Buffalo Exchange is also limiting that each person can only sell up to 50 items. And this way is to allow enough time for the associates to go through all the items that you bring in, and also allow for the next seller to come in at their designated appointment time. So now let me show you what items I'm planning to sell. Hopefully I can get some cash out of it, but this was also stuff I was looking to get rid of anyways. So here, just turn this around. So I have this bag filled with clothes I'm gonna bring. I don't have much. I have a couple button-up shirts from J. Crew that don't really fit me anymore. And I have an old turtleneck sweater and a few pairs of jeans that don't really fit me. These are all somewhat like lightly worn, but great condition. So I'm hoping I can sell these. Another thing to note is Buffalo Exchange does look at the condition of your items, so don't expect to bring in clothes that are torn or like super worn out, because they're most likely not gonna buy it. Try to bring in stuff that are lightly worn or doesn't show signs of wear, if anything, to just increase your chances of making sure you can get some cash back. And then I think they also post on their website about what type of items they're looking to buy, and it's usually seasonal. So like now it's the winter time, so things like long pants or long shirts, sweaters, those would be in trend, versus like the summertime when they'll be buying things like shorts or short sleeve shirts. There are a few other consignment stores out here, like Beacon's Closet or L Train Vintage. A lot of stores I know in the East Village and Williamsburg area that sell secondhand. So if you're looking to, you can also sell at those locations. If you guys know any other locations that you can sell clothes or buy secondhand, please leave a comment down below. I'd love to know even more. So one more tip. For those of you who are looking to sell to Buffalo Exchange and other consignment stores, and this actually has, wasted a lot of my time in the past, so I just wanted to share this tip with you. So if you're someone who uses mothballs when you store clothes or any type of harsh fragrances, make sure you air out the items beforehand or you launder them, because if the buyers at Buffalo Exchange get a whiff of any mothball scent, they will immediately give you back the items, and also they would all give back any of the items that were together. So if they think one item smells like mothballs and it was in a bag and touching like seven other items that may not have that scent, they will return all of it to you. So just be careful with that, because there's been numerous times that I had to bring my items back because something smells like mothballs. She just moved to LA, go to UCLA, and she drive a Maserati. Then she got a body, she be tryna party. She be tryna party. Okay, so I just finished selling my clothes at Buffalo Exchange. I ended up able to sell everything that I showed earlier in the video, along with an old jacket. And just to show you, I got 5610 in cash from selling my clothes, which is unexpected, but I mean, seems like a lot, so pretty happy with selling it. So now I'm actually walking towards Washington Square Park, because I need to use the bathroom. So if you're ever in the area, Washington Square Park has a great public restroom. Trying to party. Surf a shawty, she just caught the wave. 24 ping, getting big. So I just finished peeing. I'm actually on my way to go meet my friends in Midtown Manhattan. And still have about an hour, so I'm thinking I'm just gonna walk it from here. It's not a bad walk, weather's not too bad. It's a crisp fall, almost winter day. So, you know, let's see how that's gonna be. Okay, so I walked all the way to Midtown. I actually stopped by H Mart to pick up some goodies for tonight. Now I have to go and pick up some pizza. So I picked up the pizza. Now heading over to Adam's place, carrying four cans of
Muckley and a giant pizza. Hopefully I don't drop anything. It was fun with all friends. Vincent Tiding.
Hi. I'm Vincent. How are you?
I'm in love with the coca.
Alright, well, let's make sure you subscribe and hit the like button down below. See you next time.